Very good evening, students. For this lecturing video session, I am going to take a new chapter, which is support reactions. Support reactions. So the definition of support reaction is the force of resistance exerted by the support on the beam is called support reaction. Let me just give a detailed explanation on beam first. A member which bends when subjected to loads applied transverse, that is perpendicular to the axis of the member, is known as beam, which means a member which bends when subjected loads transverse, which is nothing but perpendicular to the axis of the member, is known as beam. Have you seen the beam in practical visibility? Yeah. See, for an example, let me just draw a simple sketch. Assume this is the column or pillar, so called pillar. So over this, a horizontal member is placed. So this is known as the beam. Got it? So let me just cite some classifications of the beams, that is different types of beams. Types of beams. So the first one is cantilever beam. Cantilever beam, simply supported beam, supported beam. Third one is overhanging beam. Overhanging beam. The fourth one is fixed beam and the continuous beam. Right. So now I am going to explain in detail about all the five beams. Let me just start with cantilever beam. Cantilever. A beam which is fixed at one end and free at other end is known as cantilever beam. So let me just draw a diagram for your better understanding. Assume this is a wall, right? And this is the beam, right? Now just listen carefully the definition. A beam which is fixed at one end and free at the other end is known as cantilever beam, right? So the next one, simply supported, isn't it? Simply supported beam. So here I'm going to draw a diagram. So assume some support is there, right? And the other end is also another one's kind of support, right? So over this a beam is placed. Over this a beam is placed, assume. Right. Now the definition for the simply supported is a beam supported or resting freely on the supports at its both ends is known as simply supported beam. That means a beam supported or resting freely on the supports. This is a support, right? It is resting on support at both ends of the beam. It is known as simply supported beam. Got it? Next one is overhanging beam. Overhanging beam. Right. Here, I am going to draw a diagram for your better understanding so that you will catch the definition here. Right. And a different support. Now look at this. This is the beam. So now, so the definition for overhanging beam is if the end portion of the beam is extended beyond the support, such beam is known as overhanging beam. That means the end portion of the beam is extended beyond the support, such beam is known as overhanging beam. Got it? So the next one is fixed beam. Isn't it? Fixed beam. It says a beam whose both ends are fixed or built-in walls is known as fixed beam. So, this is one wall and this is the beam and which is fixed with another wall. So now listen carefully. See, a beam whose both ends are fixed or built-in walls is known as fixed beam. The last but not the least one, that is continuous beam. The definition of continuous beam is a beam which is provided more than two supports is known as continuous beam. Kind of support. So this is another kind of support and support. So over this, the beam is being placed. The horizontal member is beam, isn't it? Right. So the continuous beam is nothing but a beam which is provided more than two supports is known as continuous beam. Right. So now what I am going to cover is the so types of load I will teach you in a different their separate video. I am going to take these different types of supports. Types of support. Support is nothing but the constraints, right? So there are four types of supports are there for this chapter. The first one is simple support or knife edged support. Right. The second one is roller support. Roller support or rocker support. The third one is hinged support or the pin joint support. The fourth one or the last one, which is fixed support or built-in support. Right. Let me just start with the simple support. So, before I just go into detail, see, when the support which doesn't allow the movement, which doesn't allow the movement, so then there will be a reaction. When the support allows the movement, then there won't be any reaction. So just keep in mind. So when I just draw the diagram, you will understand in a better way. So this is a simple beam, isn't it? So simple support. So this is the beam, this is the support, right? Assume a point A. Here it is only one support, that is a simple, that means the ordinary, the normal support, right? Here the reaction would be, so only one reaction will be there. The reason behind it allows the horizontal movement, right, and the rotation or the movement, and there won't be any vertical movement, there is vertical motion, therefore it resists to the vertical motion, so therefore there will be a reaction. So that is vertical reaction. So vertical reaction at point A. So as far as simple support is concerned, only one reaction would be there, that is the vertical reaction. So next one is the roller support or rocker support. Right. So this can be specified in couple of ways. So if it is a roller, you can, this is the surface, we can assume, and this is the roller, over there the beam or load is being applied. So this is roller, right, and the rocker is nothing but, so roller can also be specified in this manner. So number of rollers, and over this a triangle, and so this is for the simple support, right? So this is the contact point A, assume, and this is the contact point A. So as far as the roller support or the rocker support is concerned, is free to rotate and translate along the surface upon which the roller rests. The surface can be horizontal, vertical, or sloped at any angle. The roller support cannot resist the lateral forces, which means, so as far as this roller support or rocker support is concerned, so the linear displacement, that is a horizontal displacement, is possible, isn't it? And the rotation is also possible, whereas the vertical movement is not possible. Where there is a restriction, restriction, there will be a reaction, right? So here, as far as roller is concerned, it can move in the horizontal displacement, so the movement is allowed, so therefore there won't be any reaction, and there will be a rotation also. So again, there is the rotation is allowed, therefore there won't be any reaction, whereas in the vertical, if you just look at it, there is a restriction, so therefore there will be a reaction. So there will be a reaction which can be denoted as VA. So for an example, this roller or rocker support is being used in the bridges. So where you could see the metal bridges, no, in that, I mean, these kind of, I mean, roller supports are being used. Got it? So next, let me take the next one, which is the hinge support or pin joint, right? Hinge, let me just take in the next page, right? So the next one is hinged support or hinged support or the pin joint support, isn't it? Pin joint support. So It can be specified in a couple of ways. That means hinged, right? Hinged can be specified in this way. Okay. So the only difference between the hinged and the roller is, because here there is no roller. So absence of roller is hinged support. So if there is a presence in the roller below this triangle, then it is a roller support, isn't it? This is roller, right? And this is a beam. If this is a pin joint, then it can be specified in this way. This is beam. This is beam. This is fixer. Right. See, as far as hinged or pin joint support is concerned, a pinned support can resist both vertical and horizontal forces, but not a moment. So look at this here. This is fixer, right? So there won't be any vertical moment, right? And here also look at it. There won't be any horizontal moment because it is been pin joint. So there won't be any moment. So there is a restriction. So what did I tell you? When there is a restriction on moment, then there will be a reaction which will takes place. So here, as far as this vertical moment is restricted, therefore there will be a reaction. And for this horizontal, there won't be any moment. So there is a restriction, right? So therefore there is a reaction will takes place. But the moment will takes place, so there won't be any reaction for the moment. So as far as this is concerned, this can be a vertical reaction will be there with the reason behind there's the vertical moment is restricted, isn't it? Similarly, the horizontal moment, is also restricted, so there will be a reaction. So the reaction would be perpendicular to this. If you just look at it, this would be perpendicular, and if you just look at it, and this would be perpendicular to that. So the reaction would be always act perpendicular to the particular surface, right? Next one is fixed support. Fixed support. So fixed support or built-in. Or built-in support. Okay. See, as far as this is concerned, here the beam is fixed. This is the beam which is fixed in the wall. So, as far as the fixed support is concerned, it can resist the linear displacement. That is x direction and y direction, that is a vertical and horizontal moment is restricted, as well as since it is fixed, the moment is also restricted. So there will be a restriction, then the reaction takes place. Since it is resisting the vertical moment, so therefore a reaction A. See, as far as the horizontal moment is restricted, so horizontal reaction. And moreover, the rotation is also restricted, that is moment, right? So the moment is also restricted. That is can be mentioned MA, right? So this is the free body diagram. So what do you mean by free body diagram? I just taught you in the previous lecture, right? So FBD, I used to say FBD. So FBD is nothing but free body diagram of a rigid body. Is a sketch which shows all the external forces, couple moments, and the reaction exerted on the structure by supports, right? So that is the definition of the free body diagram. Got it? So the I just taught you the different types of beams, right? So the different, what are the different types of beams? So which I taught you, so cantilever beam, simply supported beam, overhanging beam, fixed beam, and the continuous beam. Then I taught you there are different types of supports. that is simple support, knife edge support, roller support or rocker support, hinged support or pin joint support, fixed support or built-in support. Right. So now just going to draw a small table. So for your better understanding, to show the number of reaction would takes place for the each supports. The simple support or simple support or the knife edge. So how many reactions? Only one reactions. Only one reaction. That is the vertical reaction. See, as far as the roller support or rocker support is concerned, only one reaction, isn't it? So then hinge support or the pin joint support, so there will be two reactions, isn't it? And as far as fixed support or the built-in support is concerned, how many reactions total? There will be three, because one vertical, one horizontal and a moment. So there will be three reactions. So in the nutshell, I just made a table for your better understanding. So this may be asked the two more questions, where the question says, I mean, how many reactions for the support, simple support or roller support or hinge support or the fixed support. So you should be in a position to immediately you will have to just write it down, the number of reactions. Just keep it in mind, the restrictions, that means the motion restrictions or the linear displacement is where there is a linear displacement or rotation is restricted, then there will be a reaction will takes place, right? Hope you have all understood the concept of the beam and the types of supports. So in the upcoming videos, I will try to solve problems based on these supports. Thank you.